Good evening, adventurers, and welcome to day 5 of our week of prayer. To begin our program tonight, I will say a short word of prayer. Pray with me. Our kind and heavenly Father, we thank you for your love and mercy. We thank you, Lord, for being there for us. We pray this evening, Almighty God, that you may be with us throughout this program. Be with us from now and forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Adventurers, welcome again. Our title for today is called, Don't Buy That Fruit. And our verse comes from Isaiah 12, verse 4, which I will read in your hearing. It says, give praise to the Lord. Proclaim his name. Make known among nations what he has done. And proclaim that his name is exalted. Adventurers, today I'm going to tell you a short story about the golden rule. I'll tell you a story about a mom and her two little kids. As mom was busy in the kitchen, she heard Yvette, the little boy, complaining. Hannah was dumping the wheelbarrow with soil all over him. She scolded and asked Hannah to stop. But Hannah was not stopping. Hannah said that he likes it when she plays with him. Hannah stopped for a while, but again the boy cried, and mom scolded Hannah to stop, and yet Hannah kept doing it and doing it over and over again. After a while, Yvette cried out more than before, and mom got a little bit concerned. She looked and saw that Hannah was pouring Yvette with sand like a flower with a watering can, just like this. Before I continue, adventurers, I know you like stories like me. Let's greet everyone else that has joined us tonight. A blessed evening to our pathfinders, to our parents, to our directors, our counselors, our pastors, our elders, and to you, our special guests, the adventurers. Now, back to the story. Mom decided it is time to stop all this. As you can imagine, she was not happy at all. She ran outside and caught Hannah. She did the same thing to her and poured her with a bucket full of sand. Now, this is on Hannah. Hannah did not like it at all. Would you like it if someone pours sand over your head? I wouldn't like it. But Hannah said, Mom, can you please stop? I don't like it. And Mom was like, no, I thought you would enjoy it. Hannah ran inside the house to clean herself up. After cleaning herself up, she remembered. She had forgotten the golden rule. And what does the golden rule say, adventurers? Say it with me. Do unto others as you would want them to do unto you. From then on, she made the choice to always remember the golden rule. And this is a reminder to you, our adventurers. When you play with your friends, when you play with your cousins, with your neighbors, and whoever that you play with or you interact with, always remember the golden rule. Do unto others as you would want them to do unto you. This year, our golden rule is very simple too. Just listen to this. I, Evidence Njenge, also best known as a powerful adventurer, that I can evangelize knowing who I am, having the faith of the one who loves me, and I promise from today that I will serve and save others by sharing the good news of Christ and with prayer. I believe I will receive all power to go out in and around the world. So as I continue to grow in Christ, this is my vow daily, that because Jesus loves me, I will go. Just like the theme verse for the year found in Psalms 127 verse 4 that says, like arrows in the hands of a warrior are my children born in one's youth. When we look into the simplicity of the pledge and law, we think it is so difficult and complicated. But if we practice with such a small task like that, we will discover how great God's love is when He shared the 10 commandments with us. You see, our parents is adventurous. We have so many stories to share around people who obey and the great results that come with it. What is very important is to note, is to not take these as rules that are boring. Then we add our own spices like Hannah. We pour bed stories of saint to the people we love. And yet we know very well that if such is poured on us, we would not like it one bit. Today, in our conclusion of arrow lessons, I want us to learn that arrows are very sharp and they are designed to poke a certain target that is aimed at. Yes, we might miss on the first tries, and even sometimes when we have been getting our targets right, sometimes we get them, not all the times. However, it is important to remember that we must at all times aim for the right target, not just to shoot because it was like fun. So until tomorrow night, our last night before the Sabbath comes, I would like you to prepare yourselves for tomorrow's sermonette, which is going to be about why. Because sounds interesting, right? I wonder whether we're asking or we are answering, but I too cannot wait. The topic for tomorrow again says why. Because in closing, I will say a word of prayer again. Pray with me. Our kind and heavenly Father, we thank you once more for being with us throughout this program. We pray, Almighty God, that you may remind us all the time to always be good to others, as we also expect others to be good to us. Be with us, Lord, from now and forevermore. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Be blessed, adventurers.